You're surely not talking about the club.
That's right, my guy. There's no need to be ashamed.
Kim. Oh, Ben. Dude, you ready?
Kid, your boy was
Kim. Pelosi ain't crazy. Even when you get the Vaseline, crazy. And try to look and make sure nobody there. It's crazy. Welcome you to another Memory Lane. Today, we will watch our first video of Timeless Tim. Caught my son watching porn. What happened if you caught your son watching porn? How will y'all react? Alright? Or, what happened if your dad caught you watching porn at that age? How will you react?
Wow! Boobs!
So I'm in my room, right? Then uh-huh. I hear his mom screaming at the top of her lungs. I rush to the living room, get there, and my son's face is shook. Remember your face.
I'm sorry, y'all. I'm sorry for what I did.
But I feel dead.
You can't lie. Like, when you scroll on Instagram, TikTok and stuff, or Snapchat, you won't even know what to react, right? Because, let me say this, I'll say around like 9 to 11, that when us boys started knowing.
Tim, you're surely not talking about the club.
That's right, my guy. There's no need to be ashamed.
Tim! Oh, Ben. Dude, you ready?
As a kid, your boy was
Tim, Pelosi ain't crazy. Even when you get the Vaseline, crazy, and try to look and make sure nobody there, it's crazy. And go hammer on it, it's crazy.
But here's the problem. Parents act like kids are doing something wrong. Like they didn't do it when they were kids. Which brings the big question. Would you rather get called by your mom or your pop?
The great part about it, you get called by your mom, it way in 10 times worse. But you get called by your pop,
humans are one of the few animals that have sex with pleasure. But at the same time, you get blamed for
following nature. That's why I truly believe sex education for children should not only be given to schools and teachers, but
it is also imperative that parents participate and teach their children about healthy relationships, love, and sex. Now by now, most of you know I'm a man, right?
I can't go too far to say raising a Gen Alpha
is different. See, these kids are raised in the age of smart technology. All they gotta do is turn on their phones, get on social media,
and all they gotta do is sexualized videos one could ask. And then lie about the age and boom. They already got Instagram and Snapchat, and all they gotta do is click what they want and scroll through and scroll, and they find what they gotta find.
Tim, what are you doing?
Nothing, Mom.
Are you watching porn?
But the creepy part about it, if your mom caught you, then you already know your pop gonna find out later. Because your mom and pop working in a pack. So if your mom find out, your pop gonna find out. You might well do go grab another pair of pants. Grab probably like 5 pair of pants. And then probably like 5 or 8 pair of shirts. And 1 pair of jacket to cover that shirt and just get ready for whooping on your life.
No, it was all good until you
finish him.
Because if your mom whooping you, then your pop will have to go in because they work in the pack.
So my God.
And of course, when it comes to adult videos, your parents always say you don't watch them.
Turn off the TV. My parents will sit there and act like nothing's happening. And all you're
Come on, what type of parent that? When I've been your age, my mom always told me, cover my eyes. I do not see all the stuff when I've been your age. So you telling me that your parents didn't care?
Wow.
And your parents didn't even try to skip it too? That's crazy. They didn't even try to skip it either.
What are they
crazy.
We've all been there, and you gotta sit there in awkward silence and act
I see.
It's where this story begins. So for this story, I'm gonna take you back to the day I caught my son cooking. So it was a short while back.
But catching your day, own kids
doing my favorite show, watching Game of Thrones. Game of Thrones is an American fantasy television series rated F.
Crazy, but I don't got one. But I had one.
Now while watching HBO, I don't know what to say to him. My ass is on watching it. Now the whole time, nothing's happening, right? But then comes the brothel scene. Now if you know, you know. So I'm watching. Halfway through the scene, my son walks into the room. Dad, can I? My son looks up the screen and my God. So I go, Junior, close your eyes. Well, my son's perplexed. He's never seen anything like this before. This was his first time. So I know his brain is like, no panic. Look to the right. There's no remote. Look to the left. Still no remote. Damn, so what's the remote? For some reason, every time you need to find the remote, it's missing. So I get to the door, slam it shut. God damn. He must have saw it. What do I do? Come on, Tim, think. See, here's the thing about parenting. Everything you did as a kid comes back on you. Even worse, no one teaches you how to be a parent.
When you have kids, you gotta learn that on your own.
Go and explain to my son what he just saw. All right, Tim, just think about it. What did mom and dad do when this happened? But here's the thing. See, I grew up in a time when parents didn't talk to their kids about their sexuality.
Like, once you become an adult, you gotta start learning certain things on your own if you become a parent at a young age, then it would be hard for your parent to actually tell you what to do because you are in that state where it's too late for you to change your mind. So,
gonna learn from the streets, my guy. So I made up my mind. So I get to my son. Hey, Junior, we need to talk. About what, Dad? About, you know, what? About, I'm gonna let your mom do it.
You know,
Son. Now I understand why parents have issues having these conversations.
Later that night,
and my son comes downstairs and wants to watch
cartoons. Now you gotta tell him about the birds and the bees.
Finish watching my show in my room, so I get to my room and continue watching my show. And then my son sits down.
You get the idea.
Remember, this is little Tim, right? And everyone's child has a little bit of themselves in them. So he says he sat down, continues watching the TV, but right before changing the channel, a sex scene pops up. I'm talking damn near the hub, my guy. Wow. Boobs. So I'm in my room, right? Then I hear his mom screaming at the top of her lungs. I rush to the living room, get there, and my son's face is shook. I look towards the screen, and oh my God. Now I can't cap. I was like,
come on, Tim, you got the real thing right in your face. Your wife can throw it to you. Why you gotta watch that? And if you got a girlfriend, wife, and
wait, I'm so proud of myself. But I gotta talk to my daddy.
You talking about the fun dad? You hear me? But you gotta be
talking about he can't get his eyes off the TV screen. So I get the remote, hit the off button, and now we gotta have the talk. Son, your mother wants me to talk to you about what you just saw on TV. But dad, what were they doing? They were. And then hit me. Wait a minute. Let me first check what he knows before giving him the information.
Don't give him the birds and bees too early.
They were butt-ass naked. Now, first of all, I was impressed. But then I was like, what the hell is this kid learning from other kids in his school? Oh, I gotta be extra
careful. I'm confused.
Son, here's the thing. Sometimes when people love each other, they
start cooking.
Cooking?
Yes, son.
Can I start cooking? I can't wait to start cooking. So my son goes to his room, and from that day forward, anytime I'm watching anything PG-13 and up, I make sure I lock the door, close the curtains, turn down the volume. Wait a minute. That's a bit. It's like I'm back to being a kid.
That's a bit too much.
Moral of the story. There's no such thing as being the perfect parent. So be a real one.
Basically, the moral of the story, it never an easy way to be a great father or a terrible mother. As long as you're there every single time and taking care of your kid and appreciating your kid and loving and your kid with all love and grace. Like, subscribe, and hit the post notification bell and hit the icon and click on this next video.